What factors affect a student's ability to learn? Research has studied the importance of teachers and peers, but does the school's physical environment also matter? This paper studies the role of heat. In laboratory settings, even moderately elevated temperatures have been shown to impair decision-making and cause discomfort. Effects that, in a classroom, may make it substantially harder for teachers and students to focus. In fact, when comparing across countries, there is a negative correlation between average annual temperature and student test scores, and the same pattern is apparent across counties in the US. Students in hotter places tend to have lower academic achievement. But to what extent does this reflect a causal relationship? Does heat inhibit learning? To answer this question, this paper uses a large-scale dataset covering the standardized test scores of millions of US high school students, linked to local daily weather data spanning the period from 2001 to 2014. These data track PSAT scores. The PSAT is a nationally standardized exam, consisting primarily of a reading and math section, and is designed to assess students' cumulative learning in high school. Over the period of this study, the exam was offered only once a year, in October, and most students first take it in 10th or 11th grade. Using these data, the authors assess whether higher temperatures over the prior school year affect students' test scores. This figure shows the distribution of average PSAT scores across counties. On average, southern counties have lower test scores relative to northern counties, and, mirroring the broader patterns seen before, there is a strong negative correlation between test scores and prior year heat exposure. But, of course, many things other than average temperature differ across these regions. In order to isolate the impact of heat, the authors focus on a sample of 10 million students who took the PSAT more than once. Consider a student who takes the PSAT twice, and suppose one exam happens to follow a hotter school year, while the other follows a cooler school year. The essence of this strategy is to ask whether the same student tends to score differently when their exam follows a hotter year. To account for other factors that might drive differences in test scores, the authors net out effects driven by the student's high school class, the year in which they took the exam, and the number of times they had already taken the PSAT. The results show that students tend to score lower following hotter years relative to their own scores following cooler years. Experiencing a 1 degree hotter school year lowers scores by 0.2% of a standard deviation. To put this number in perspective, the average gain in PSAT scores between 10th and 11th grades is about 0.3 standard deviations. In other words, a 1 degree hotter school year reduces learning by close to 1% of the expected gain over that year. This figure shows that very hot temperatures are particularly damaging. Each point shows how test scores are affected by the number of days in a given temperature range during the prior year. Relative to a school day in the 60s, cold days have little impact on test scores. But above 70 degrees, the negative impact increases almost linearly with temperature. The effects of heat exposure are also cumulative and persistent. Heat exposure up to 4 years prior to the exam has a negative impact on test scores, and the cumulative impact of increased exposure over multiple years is 3 to 5 times larger than the impact of just the prior year. Of course, it's possible that higher temperatures are simply correlated with other factors that affect academic achievement. But the authors show that their results are not driven by higher exposure to pollution or by adverse economic conditions that might be affected by extreme weather. Moreover, the test score effects are driven by school day exposure to higher temperatures. Controlling for summer heat and weekend heat does not affect the results. Thus, these findings are consistent with the idea that heat directly inhibits students' ability to learn. There is, however, a straightforward investment that can mitigate these effects: school air conditioning. AC substantially reduces the negative impact of hot school days on academic achievement. A back-of-the-envelope calculation suggests that the present value of AC in hot areas, such as Houston, Texas, far exceeds its cost and is approximately $2.1 million per year for each 1,000-student high school. Finally, the authors show that the negative effects of heat exposure disproportionately impact minority students. The impact of prior year heat on Black and Hispanic students is roughly 3 times larger than the impact on white students, and estimates indicate that between 3-7% of the racial gap in PSAT scores can be explained by differences in the temperature environment. This appears to be driven both by lower levels of AC penetration in schools with more minority students, and by the fact that Black and Hispanic students tend to live in hotter locations. Overall, this paper provides evidence that heat exposure disrupts learning. These results highlight the importance of the physical environment in affecting educational outcomes, and are particularly relevant in a world of climate change and rising temperatures. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related research. This includes work exploring the effect of heat on a broad range of economic outcomes, papers studying the link between school infrastructure investments and educational achievement, and finally, research on the racial achievement gap.